Delhi, Gurkha, Calcutta, Simla, there must surely be some exotic reason for Khandallah's Indian street names, mustn't there? Well, possibly not, according to Wellington history specialist Gabor Doth, who says it may all come down to a mundane matter of local government reorganization after World War I. The northern Wellington suburb used to be a farming community, providing milk and produce to the capital. Early residents included farmers John Casey and James Nairn, who gave his name to Nairnville Park. Khandallah's Indian influence is frequently attributed to the arrival of Captain James Andrew, who had served in what was then British India. Read more, Curious City, where do our street names come from and how do you say them? Street history, Khandallah's slice of India. The suburb is said to have been named after Khandallah, in Rajasthan, northwestern India, and various accounts claim its name means hills and valleys, home of the god, or resting place of God. The suburb itself was named after the old Khandallah homestead, built in 1884, on the corner of Burma Road. Its streets include Delhi Cress, named after India's current capital, and Calcutta Street after the Bengali city, now called Kolkata, that was the capital until 1911. Gurkha Cress is a throwback to Nepalese soldiers or the Gurkha Brigade, regiments from the Indian Army transferred to the British Army after the partition of India in 1947. Kashmir Avenue is named after the northwestern region of Kashmir, the center of Hinduism early in the first millennium, and Simla Cress after the Himalayan hill town that became the summer capital of British India. Some sources say Andrew named Khandallah, as well as its railway station, after gifting land for the Wellington to Manawatu Railway, built about 1894. But Andrew died in Palmerston North on March 3, 1893, and the suburb's streets were not given Indian names until the 1920s, Toth says. One thing is therefore clear, James Andrew can't have had any involvement with the renaming of the streets. He also points out that in papers past, the National Library's digitized newspaper collection, the first reference to Khandallah in relation to the suburb was May 1873, and that stories of Andrew naming the area in the 1880s might be false. He may still have been involved, but it must have been earlier. Khandallah was part of the Onslow Borough, becoming part of Wellington only in 1919. During the amalgamation of various boroughs into Wellington, including Melrose, Onslow, Karori, and Miramar, there were many street name duplications, and Toth believed the Khandallah names were changed simply to give them a point of difference. He also disputes the interpretation of Khandallah as meaning resting place of God. His own investigations found Khan translated from Hindi to English as section, or plot of land. From his research, the correct pronunciation should be Khandallah, with a pronounced H. In her book The Streets of My City, Wellington historian Fanny Irvine Smith says Andrew gave the land for the Khandallah station on the condition that all trains stopped at the suburb. Irvine Smith wrote that Simla Cress could have been the first Indian street name, in about 1925. She attributed the naming of Simla Cress to S.C.G. Vickers, one of the early settlers of the area, who allegedly named his house Simla to align with the name Khandallah. But there is evidence that Captain Edward Battersby, who worked for the East India Company, could also have named the streets. Battersby lived in Khandallah 20 years before Andrew did, and owned a 450-acre property called Khandallah. Andrew, meanwhile, continues to be a part of Wellington's history. His body was returned to the capital after his death, and he was buried at the same plot as his wife in the Bolton Saint Cemetery, Stuff.